like, share, subscribe. HCB2 World.
Yo, YouTube, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So you guys already know how this goes. New week, new fairy tale chapter, baby. With every new fairy tale chapter, you know I got that review for you. You know I got it. And this week we got chapter 524, and it definitely has some interesting developments, especially considering that your boy Acting Logia showed up. But you know what? We're gonna talk about that here in a second. Before I get to that, if at any time you agree with or like what I have to say in the video, go ahead and leave me a thumbs up, alright? Makes your boy feel good. Also, if you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe. Anybody who comments on my videos can tell you I'm extremely good about responding, and I love making new friends, so come join the team. Other than that, guys, I'm not going to waste too much time on the intro. You know how this goes. Let's go! Now, to start things off, let's talk about the only thing that really matters at this point, Acting Logia. Like, what the fuck is going on right now? Like, what is going on with Acting Logia, man? Now, to be honest, when last chapter hit, I don't know if I looked at the shit wrong or what, but I could have sworn that he landed where August and Gildarts were. So I'm figuring like we're going to have a three-way fight, four-way fight if you include Connor, right? But turns out he actually landed where Urza was. And dude, I'm telling you, man, the shit that he did to Eileen's body was not right, man. I'm like, bro, like how you, not only are you going to disrespect the dead, but how you going to do that shit right in front of Urza? Like, she just lost her mom, man. You just straight stomped her mom in the body putty, you know? It was terrible. Now, from this point, man, you know that at one point, Acting Logia talked about wanting to destroy the dragons, or in this case, he was actually talking about the dragon slayers. So like, what's next, man? Like, where the hell is he going from here? I think since where he landed, I don't know if he's going to attack Wendy or what. Obviously, Wendy being the closest dragon slayer, but she might be so weak, you know, compared to him, that he might feel like he needs to go somewhere else. I don't know. Hopefully, Urza's not dumb enough to try to attack this dude, because if so, there is a 125% chance that not only is she getting that ass beat, she's probably going to get the same shit her mom just got. Now, let's jump to the fight between Natsu and Xerath. There was definitely some parts that shocked me here. One, I was a little shocked at how strong Xerath was. There's a point where he goes to kick Natsu, and Natsu actually, he accurately deflected the kick, you know? He accurately blocked, but Xerath was still so powerful that he sent Natsu flying. So I'm like, holy shit, man. So now this kind of make me wondering, what can he actually do? You know, what kind of powers does he have? What kind of strength does he have? Because I did not see him kicking Natsu like that, you know? I didn't see that shit coming. Now, in terms of that, on top of that, you know, Natsu, we already know that Xerath intended for Natsu to destroy him. But now that Natsu doesn't have that power, like, what's next? Granted, you know, Natsu says instead of using the power of Ignil, he's going to use the power of me, but like, what the hell does that actually mean? Now, I think that Natsu might actually be able to destroy Xerath still, and here's why. Granted, we saw that Natsu came back after the time skip stronger, but we never seen him like full strength, you know? We saw that his flames got so high that they could melt the magic stadium, but other than that, you know, what can he do? We haven't seen the limits of Natsu's new power, so who's to say that Natsu's power isn't actually stronger than what he got from Ignil? I'm guessing that Natsu might be a lot stronger than we think, or a lot stronger than we've been shown so far, and I think he might actually be able to pull this off. But for right now, I don't think the fight between him and Xerath really matters. I think what's important is that they find a way to take down Acting Logia. And I'm starting to think, you know, if Acting Logia was such a big threat and Xerath wanted to die so much, how come he just didn't have Acting Logia destroy him, you know? Like, that's weird to me that he's trying to die, but he really just wants Natsu to kill him. Like, he has a bunch of options as to how he can check out of here. Granted, you know, I can understand if he maybe wanted to be killed because Natsu was his brother, and that's kind of like the nicer way of dying, I guess. Die by the hands of somebody you love, but who knows? If that man really wanted to get out of here, he would have destroyed Acting Logia, he would have had Acting Logia destroy him. Now, that also brings me to the reason why I don't think Xerath is evil. If Xerath was really evil, why would he want to destroy Acting Logia to begin with? I think he wants to get Acting Logia out of here because, granted, he really hasn't done anything evil. He's talked a big game. He said, hey, yeah, I'm this now. I'm going to destroy the Roar. But really, he hasn't done shit. He sent this Spriggan 12. That's about it. But he hasn't gotten his hands dirty yet. Now, not only that, but considering the fact that he's trying to get rid of Acting Logia, I think he's actually trying to do mankind a service. I don't really know what he wants Fairy Heart for. I have some theories, you know, but at this point, you know, I'm not going to speculate. I'll save that for another video. But I don't think that the fight between Natsu and Xerath is going to take off just yet. I think they're going to team up to take on Acting Logia, and I think we're going to see that within the next chapter or two. Now, to end this wonderful, wonderful chapter, let's talk about Gildarts and August. Man, I used to think that August was just like this old-ass wizard who was strong as shit, you know, and he was cool. But the last two chapters, this dude has really gotten creepy, especially when it comes to Connor. Like, he gets that weird-ass smile, and I don't know, man. Shit makes me real uncomfortable. But now we got this chapter, you know, and it looked like for a second they were going to stop, you know, maybe team up and fight Agnologia, because he said, oh, looks like we're out of time. Oh, looks like this, looks like that, you know. So I thought that maybe they would stop and face the real threat, which is Agnologia. But then he goes and does some weird shit, man. He asks Gil Darcy if he loves his daughter. And of course, Gil Darcy is going to say, yeah, it's his fucking kid. Of course, he's going to say, yeah. But then he's like, oh, well, I wonder what kind of pain you'd go through if I kill her. And then he gets that weird smile. Like, who says shit like that? Who does shit like that, man? I think I caught it earlier. I think that Gil Darcy is going to die, but I think he's also going to take August with him. Unfortunately, I'm glad Connor showed up, but it doesn't look like she's going to do anything but get in the way. And unfortunately, I think trying to protect his daughter, Gil Darcy is going to bite it, but not before he takes out August. So I think Gil Darcy will take out August. August will die, and then Gil Darcy is going to die in the hands of Connor. And not only that, you know, let's talk about Connor for a second. What the fuck does Fairy Glitter do? Like, dude, oh, I have no idea what this attack does. It's supposed to be one of the three craziest attacks that Fairy Tail as a whole guild owns. But every time she uses this shit, it does nothing. Like, I have not seen this attack work once. So I don't know if it's maybe some magic that works over time, or maybe certain conditions gotta be met for it to work. But I wanna know what the hell this shit does, alright? I want to know. Well, guys, that's going to do it for this review. Hopefully, you enjoyed it. I apologize for getting it out late, but life happens, man. But I always try to make sure that I get my stuff to you guys, because I know you guys enjoy it. And on top of that, I enjoy making it. So I apologize for getting it out late, but hopefully, you can still enjoy it. If you like the video, please go ahead and leave me a thumbs up. I would greatly appreciate it. Also, if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe on the way out, all right? Make sure you subscribe. Other than that, guys, that's going to do it for this video. I'm your boy, Heels. Come back. Two. I'll catch you guys later. Do great. Be great. Peace.